Hello and welcome to this video overview about Dice Parser's Discord Dice Roller bot. First, let's see how to invite Dice Parser into your server. Go to rollysteam.org, then click on Roll on Discord page, and as a final step, click on the invitation link. Select the server, and you are all set. To check that everything is okay, just roll few commands. If it doesn't work, please check bot permission. The default prefix is exclamation mark, but you can change it. To display the Dice Parser documentation, just run the help command, please RTFM. The online documentation describes in details the command syntax. Now let's roll some unusual dice based on range. We can roll dice and do some math. Dice parser can sort dice results in both ways. You can keep dice. Unkept dice are ignored. This is a K operator. Dice parser can count successes for you. This is a C operator. Dice Passer provides many ways to reroll die. Reroll. Explode. Add. Many operators need a condition to work properly. Let's take a look at the syntax of those conditions. You can change the color of dice thanks to the P operator. To ignore any die that does not respect the condition, you must use the F operator. You want to pick up values from a list? Guess what? Dice Passer provides a list operator, the L operator. In some cases, if operator can help you to build a real powerful command. Let's see some cool stuff you can do with Dice Parser and math. Dice Parser can be used as a calculator. Value list is a more advanced operator. It allows you to check that the rest of the command will behave as expected. Finally, Dice Parser can accept formatting instructions to amend the output. Placeholder in final output can help you build a real custom output and to set the level of details you want. Dice Parser provides a configuration tool to manage how the result is shown on Discord. By default, DicePerser does not mention the user who wrote the command, but it is possible to change that. One of the key features of DicePerser is a macro. A macro is a way to shorten a command. First, I would like to show you some long commands. So we want to make them shorter to improve the player experience. First, we have to identify changing parts in the command. Commonly, the number of dice is often a changing part. So in the first command, nothing changed. In the second one, we want to change the first number and the last one. And for the third command, we want to be able to change the first number and the validator of the count operator. The second step is to select a meaningful pattern. A pattern is a part which will change to the real command. For example, if your game is called Werewolf, you can pick a W as a pattern. The third step is to select the right replacement method. To help you with that, I design a little graph. Let's pick P as pattern. Our first example has its parameters at the beginning and at the end, so the default replacement method is enough. It is why I set false at the end of the macro definition. The second example has no parameters, so simple replacement methods is just fine. It is why I set false at the end of the macro definition. In the macro definition, the pattern is more complex because I have to define where to find parameters. In the command part, I define where they should go, where parameters should go. And at the end, I don't forget to set to true to activate regular expression replacement. At any time, I can list all defined macros on my server. and I can remove them using their ID. You can see Dice Parser source code on KDE GitLab. There you can fork the project or ask for new features. Dice Parser needs your support. You can do it through three platforms. Links are on the official website or below in the description. Thanks for watching. If you have any question or if you need more details about some Dice Parser features, let me know in the comment section. You can also reach us on Discord, link in the description.